लाइव नाउ। हेलो
यूडी,
व्हाट वी आर टेलिंग योर फॉलोअर दैट यू स्टार्टेड अ लाइव वीडियो।
हां, या द ऑप्शन विल कम,
सो फॉर देम दैट ऑप्शन विल कम। हसन ऑलरेडी जॉइंड। आई थिंक हसन इज कमिंग ऑन संडे। हसन इज ऑन ट्यूसडे आई गेस। Yeah, I'll manage. That's how it is, no? Sohan, hello, hi guys. Sharif, this guy Sharif is bodybuilding and all, huh? Yeah, I think Sharif is the one who he's the one who has the guy who does this muscle job, you know? I mean, his Camaro was done by Race Dubai. Larry Wheels, and he was doing this. So Sharif, I think, is with him. Rob Conway, hello. Hi, Adnan. Adnan is Arbab, Baba. He's into track racing and all. I really want him to also to come. Okay, and hey, buddy, how are you? Okay, what's up? How's life? Okay, so there were some questions that I got. What was it? Go ahead. We'll start with that, and then I'll tell some stories, and then I'll do a Q&A, and I'll answer all those questions that you guys have. I'm gonna post it on YouTube. Yeah. I am good. Adnan Khan, how are you? Okay. Start.
Yep.
What's the first question?
Question by Rohan Sharma. If you had to recommend a good way to practice drifting,
Good way to practice drifting. Hey Zeus, what's up? Why are there so many alternators? Yeah, alternators on the shell, yes. I sell alternators, na, that's why. The size of the big boy. I am miskeen, Baba, big boy, it seems. Gareeb aadmi. Alternator, no. The good way of drifting is... I think one of the Z platforms was always good. That's where it all started. You know, back in the 80s and all, when they started drifting. A86, yes, obviously, but then is it attainable? Where am I from? I'm Bangladeshi. Yes, I am. I never thought you'll ask me this question, but yeah. Born, brought up here, but yeah, I'm Bangladeshi. And the 86 is, it's rare to find. Again, the 4GE, 4AEGE, AGE something, that's the engine. And if that's attainable, then good. If not, then get one of the 350Zs. That's how it starts. 350Z is a very good platform. Pedro, that is... we can't say that now. We have to get Pedro's permission to say that. But yeah. I think 350Z is where I'll start.
Okay. And Lexus, Sujit's brake fix repeat. Tell me about the hidden turbo project.
The hidden turbo project. See, the hidden turbo project was a very, very funny thing. What happened was, we started getting what we do is custom jobs, right? So we get all these people to come down. They give us their designs. They give us their, you know, build. This is how they expect their build to look, or you know, Challenger, Satpak, Camaro, SS. Wait, I'll come to that. Let me tell the hidden story first. So what happened is. So this client came in with R31, beautiful R31, and a classic number, right and drive. And he said, Rashid, could you do a hidden project? I think he lives in Ras Al Khaimah, that's the reason. And we said, okay, get us some designs, let's us also look into it. And slowly, eventually, because every process has, you know, I have to get the approval, then do it, then I have to figure it out. And we started doing that, and then he started giving me designs. That's where it started, but eventually it was my ideas. I have a good team behind me, so I didn't have to, you know, break my head like the first couple of years. What are you doing? Nothing, telling stories. That's all I do. I tell stories and I listen to stories. I love listening to stories. That's how people have come to know me a lot nowadays. Yes, live. Hey Nathan. Nathan is from Belgium. This guy is one of our first followers. Nathan is been with us since I think the second post, or I think when Amin's episode came out in January back, he started following us, and the support that this guy has shown us all the way from Belgium. Thank you, Nathan, for coming. I'm really surprised that, you know, people do listen to all of our stories. Best story so far. Beat story? Best story. I think you're asking about the best story. There's many aspects to say this. There is some wild stories. There is some emotional stories. There is some, over-the-top stories. And so every category is there. So if you ask me which category stories you are always you want to know, I can tell you. Are you a good driver? Driving is everything to me. And Nathan, really, man, thank you. I like your face. Thank you so much, man. Good job, guys. Really nice knowing details. I'm trying to cover. See, when it started, it was all about me. I mean, I'm not so self-centered, but then I couldn't do a vlog. Like, you know, oh, guys, see, I'm doing this. I couldn't do that. What I started with was, you know, put a camera, let's talk. Let's just talk. That's the plan. And it was a phone camera back then. And then we said, okay, you know, let's get something professional. Let's get something, you know, something that works out for United. Hello, Mr. Liverpool. United doesn't suck. We are in a transition period. This is football. This is very different. Do not talk about football. Football, United, that's it. That's all matters. Farhan, our gym buddy. Oh my God, Farhan. Hey, Raheel. Raheel just came an hour ago. He wanted to do this exhaust tips, and I think he had somewhere to go, so he's going to come back. Hey, Raheel, what's up, man? Tarek, thank you, man. Thank you. Hi, how are you? How did I get my 34? My 34 story is very simple. I just got it from a friend. I mean, yeah, you guys asked me as if something I had to do with it. But then I got it from a friend. And they just continued. It's how fast it is. I've driven it 230. That's how fast it went. After that, I couldn't. That's how fast I could have taken it. It is at the end of Jebel Ali. Towards Abu Dhabi, yeah, and that's a good stretch of road. And that's a dog.
What's your next project car?
Next project car. See, next project car. There's always your next project car. There's no stopping it. There's no way I can say, oh, this is my last car and this is the last project I'm gonna do. So the recent, if the question changes and says, what's your recent project car? I'm still acquiring the Devil Z from Vangan Midnight. The exact blue, the one that Akio drove in the entire series of 26 episodes. And what happened now is, what I want to do is, I just swapped RB25 right now in it. There's an RB25 in it now. The shaft is throwing me a bit of trouble because the diff is from one of the old Zs. So I need to, you know, make a propeller, make the shaft. And yeah, I'll figure that out. On an expat. How are you going to fit on a mini? Man, Raheel, bro, I know you are, you know, bigger size than me, but I don't fit in a mini. I do not fit in a mini. You bought your BM right now. Please bring the mini next time. Because my size, like with the tummy, I'm like, oh, mini, I can't move the tummy. So that's what happens with me. Really, it happens with me. Trust me. Hey, Omar, what's up? How do you register? How do you register? It's a long story. We'll keep that for some other time. But yeah, definitely. I will visit me sometime, Tarek, and we will speak about it. What else? I don't really. Yeah, Raheel, you can laugh at me as much as you want, but bro, I do not fit in a mini. Like, I need the space. My knees are with the steering, and I don't know. It doesn't fit. Farhan, you keep laughing, man. Let's go out. Let's have fun. You're always busy in gyms and all. Oh, how's your fight? You guys, if you don't know, Farhan is I think into UFC, if I'm not wrong. And
he won yesterday's fight.
He won yesterday's fight. Farhan, did you win yesterday's fight? 4-0. What's your first car? My first car, it's a vague story. So before my first car officially was a Daihatsu. Before that, I got a BMW M3 for some days. So what happened, I mean, I didn't technically own it. What happened with that was, so BMW M3s, especially the E46 models, they have the rev meter, the 8, RPM 8 is yellow, RPM 9 is red. So every time you switch off the car after you park it, you turn on the car and whatever your last rev meter was, it shows, it blinks, it shows, you know, that okay, this is the last time the car was driven at such speed. It's driven at that, you know, that such RPM you have shifted the last time. And my father found out that I'm being rev limiting at 9000 RPM, I'm shifting the car every time. And he was so concerned. He's like, listen, I know you're gonna die in this car, so no, I'm not gonna give you. And I enjoyed that car at 260. When you drive, you can still have a burger in your hand and you can go like, you know, is it 260? That's how I had that car. And then the Daihatsu, that ended up flipping. I do have an episode on that, that I flipped that car 7 times. A friend of mine ended up breaking the front windshield and getting me out. Yeah, so that also happened. Rashid bhai, I wanna say you sorry. Yup, it's okay, don't worry. Don't have to worry, man, I'm right here. What next? What did you ask? On an expat, Tariq, let's talk. My story of Skyline is already there. It's on my birthday that came out. The Paul tribute. That was it. My first car. Hey bro, on opinion Camaro or a cat spat back challenges. Camaro and challenges. American 6.2. I think they have the, at least not like Mustang. They don't go out of hand. Sorry Mustang guys, but Mustang. I saw a guy, I don't remember this guy's name. He posted a picture of his Mustang saying in the front bumper there's a sticker that says insert crowd here. I was laughing. I'm like this guy just made my day. Like, he knows Mustangs are crowd killers. He literally printed a sticker in his front bumper that says insert crowd here. What? So if you ask me, Challenger and Camaro engines are good. Dodge again, Challenger, they're performing well. I still remember the Mopar pack that they got out for SRT. When the prototype came out, and James May, I think, drove it. The other guy, Richard Hammond, he took it on the track and the drag strip, and he was like, whoa! You know the Vin Diesel thing that you see, and it actually happened in real life. So that was fun. So if you ask me, I like the Camaro engine more than the Challengers. Yeah, Challengers are good, but then Camaro has the space with me, has that love with me. Crazy story. Hala hala, Asanga! He's my best friend, Asanga. I have grown up with this guy. I have seen days and night without money, without car, with heartbreaks. I have met Asanga. You're at work. He's in Vietnam right now. You need to come back. You need to sit here and tell stories with me. One of the stories with Asanga was, Asanga, you remember when we got my first car? My first Daihatsu. And we don't know the roads. We don't know any road. We don't know. I think the year was 2009. And the entire Sheikh Zayed Road, Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed, now it was Emirates Road then, Etihad Road, it was packed. You can't move. People have been in the traffic for 4 hours because the rain is that bad. And Asanga was like, bro, I need to go home. The bus will take. I said, you know what, Asanga? Hop in. Let's go Sharjah. You know, we don't know how to go Sharjah till now. No Google map, no GPS, nothing. We see the signboard, we'll go Sharjah. How? Okay, we know there is a road bypass, and the bypass road is a bit far. We said, okay, no problem. Bypass road, we'll reach. Okay, we start driving. Asanga, if you remember, I think that was in Khawanich. So we ended up in a place in Khawanich where it's like dark road, twist, turn, dark, wall, that's it. And we were, you know, press our brakes. Why is a wall in the middle of the road? But you get down and there is this smell of this dunk, you know, the one that used for fertilizers and all. We were like, oh my god, people are dead here. Oh my god, we'll not reach, you know. This is the end of our life. We take the car back. We're like, let's get out from here. And we ran back. Somehow we reached Khawani's roundabout, which eventually I took today morning. That's why I was laughing before the live, you know, that story just popped up. Somehow we reached Sharjah's entrance. That, oh, this is Sharjah, we can go. Now, till Dubai, I know the radars somehow, you know, that time we are like, oh, radar hunters and all that. So we got down. Now, Asanga does this amazing thing, okay? He's my spotter. So what he does is, opens the window, sits on the car, puts his head out, he's sitting on the car, like, bro, there's a radar in front, slow down. And I have to slow down. I push. That Daihatsu story, I mean, we did this till we reached Clock Tower in Sharjah. I was like, I don't know what the radars are. And this guy's sitting on my car. And outside, with the wind, with the, you know, all those bugs throwing on your face. And he's sitting like, bro, there's a radar coming. Oh, Asanga, these were the days we got born. And please, this was my childhood with Asanga. This was just the start. This fucker, sorry. This guy, I don't know if I'm allowed to say this. He started dating a girl and I was the co-driver. I was the driver and he's with her, you know. My car, I'm driving in Jumeirah, going around places, and he's busy. Asanga, you remember? That's one of our funny stories, you know, that I was always been there. I mean, I've grown up with him. So, yeah, I have so many stories. He got a Colt. He got a Micra something. No. The Mitsubishi's one. Something else is called. Compression or electric. Wait, I'm coming to that. So he got one of those hatchback Mitsubishi's. Masanga nowadays. So his plan before traveling to Vietnam was swap a Colt engine. Okay. Don't do that, Haramko. Don't do that. Colt engine, turbo, all-wheel system, that's important. So yeah, that's our one of our childhood stories. Please show my R34. Yes, sure. You always see that in pictures. I mean, every night I post. Every night, whatever I've done, I go home, tuk, post. Morning, I wake up, I wake up with likes. Oh, that's how I wake up. Crowd killer. Best story of Eclipse. Eclipse man, by mistake, I sold in the same bloody office. Came, handed me the cash. I'm like, okay, what did I say this? So yeah, combustion or electric, bro? If I can burn electric cars, I don't know. Electric cars has never satisfied my raw need. I don't know how to say this. I need that sound. I need that. I don't even see the RPM. You know, I just shift. I know. I don't know how will it go with electrical. Probably I'll be selling. Now that you see alternators behind me. And sometime you'll be seeing battery. You know, this red battery is 100 horsepower. This black battery is 5000 horsepower. Apparently. So, yeah. You can't say anything to me. Oh, Farhan. Oh, you got offended, bro. Bro, I don't have something to give. So, yeah. That's how it is. I've seen the car when I went to GCF. Yes. I need to find this guy. And I need to know what the story behind why he put that insert crowd here sticker. So yeah. Best German car. Can I include classics? If I can include classics. I mean, that's Pedro. Our Pedro. He was the host yesterday for our show. Thank you, Pedro, for doing this. And sorry, some leak happened here before you came. So, if I can choose old ones, I'll probably go with the BMWs. Amazing. My E30 got half-cutted. that our E31, that Sujit knows the story. It got half cut into pieces. So yeah, that's best German car for me. I think BM, one of the old BMs from the E30 series, one of the 8 series. Okay, now what I don't understand is people have been, you know, complaining their asses off that, oh, Supra is the BM, Supra is BM, you know. Okay, look at the MK3, look at the 8 series. Look at the MK3, look at the 8 series. Like, are you dumb? I mean, it's exactly the same. It's pop-ups. It's the same pop-up headlight, it's the same grill. I mean, it looks same. So why are you complaining when the MK5 and a Z4? Power level, it's good. Okay. I'll come back soon. You need to come back soon. There's no I will. There's no will here. Your will is not here. You will come back. Tell your story. Oh my God, right? That car, man. I will buy it again. I will. One guy in Baladia, he works, he has it. In Rashidia. So yeah, I will buy that. Hey, Bin Saif. Is the MK4 a daily drive car? If you keep it stock, yes. If you keep it stock, any car is a daily drive car. That's how the company intended it to be. That's how it started. So yeah, you can daily drive it. That's no issues. I'm not faced any issues with my own, at least. Then again, do I daily drive? Next up, Supra R34. Moment of silence. Supra R34, I don't know. Both have their own pleasures. I enjoy both. I've never said, oh, that is good or this is bad. Dead end, bro, farmers around, yeah, Haramkhor. That place is still like that. Okay, yeah, in front, the knock opened and all that. But then when you take that left and that curve starts, yeah, still like that. Red Chili, you asked me my biggest find. My biggest find, I don't think I can say this, but it's in a six-digit number. I think six-digit, right? Yeah. At one go. The recent biggest find that I got is, so when quarantine started, I started, obviously you can't go to the track, you can't drive, all that. So they open from 6 a.m. to 8 p.m. 6 a.m. exactly. Falaj Mullah, there's this road, Umal Quwain. It's amazingly twist, turn, like at 160 you can enter the turn. And it's a very, very beautiful place. And end of the road is the Maliha's, Madam's police station. That roundabout that has four exits from Alain side, Dubai side, Sharjah side, Ajman side. So that's the end of the road. So till you reach there, if you enter from Falaj Mullah, it's a very beautiful road. There's an ad knock and then you run. I kept doing this and I enjoy it. I'm like, okay, 160 I took this turn, let's try to take it at 180. Let's see if I can, you know, balance it out. So when I started doing this, nothing happened. It was fine. And then I found out I think 10 days later, 1,000, 5 1,000 dirham fines I have, because the road was 80 and I was at some 160, 170, hold it at Faisal, pomp, he's a teacher, so he usually uses that road to go to his school and, you know, come back because he lives in Rasul Khan. And pomp said, Rashid, they keep the radars for us. I was surprised. I was like, Pomp, you should have told me this before. And that's where I found out that yes, they keep radar, the hidden radars. Because I memorized those five radars that was there. The entire stretch of 10 kilometers had five radars. And it was like, you know, back of my head, close my eyes, I know. Radar in front of the mosque, in front of this U-turn, there's that radar. And I'm going to, you know, slow down at that places. All mobile radars I got. So yeah, all five of them, I tried this. Instead of the way, it's better to win exhaust. Yes, exhaust giveaway, I'll give away. I will talk about this. I will. And thank you everyone. 1,000 followers, thank you. I can't thank you guys enough. When it started, I really enjoyed the backlash that I was getting. Why? Who will come to the show? Why they will come to talk to you? Who are you? Who will listen to their stories? Yeah, there are people from Belgium, people from Las Vegas, people from London, they listen to our story and their messages. Then they say, you know, we like the stories. We want to come one day down to your show. One guy said this, I think I sent you that day, right? The one guy sent that year that I want to build my life in such a way that one day I'm able to sit in your show and talk about my car stories. And that was goosebump moment for me. I was like, wow, really? You wanna build a career out of it? And so yeah, what cars were you guys in? We were in a Terios Daihatsu. That was, the torque was good. High end, nothing, huh? I think 100 horsepower we had. But that car, again, those days, 10 dirham petrol, 10 dirham. From Karama, from that 10 dirham petrol, I still remember, from Karama we reached Sharjah. From Sharjah we reached entrance of Umm Al Quwain. We bought a car for a friend, Adi, where the hell is he? Adi bought that 316. On the way back, when we reached, I think, close to Sharjah, we refueled. All this way, we are just roaming around. And also, we were searching cars. So we were like, oh, that 316 is good. Oh, that. Because those days, obviously, no Dubizel, no nothing. So you have to go to the showrooms, you know. And we heard in far regions, the cars are cheaper compared to Dubai or Abu Shagara. Asanga, Asa Abu Shagara. our stories. So we said, okay, let's go, you know, far region. We started traveling. With 10 dirham petrol, I still remember, we went. On the way back, the light came on. That's the reason I was like, oh man, let's put petrol, give me 10 bucks, guys, coins and all that. So yeah, exhaust giveaway, we'll talk. Which car is reliable? Charger, Challenger. Reliability is completely on the way you drive. If you ask me, reliability is completely on the way you drive. It's okay, if factory problem starts coming, it usually starts, I've seen mostly in Mustangs. That's where I've started seeing it coming, the factory troubles. Camaro, again, no, I've not seen so much. I'm actually doing a Camaro right now. For some reason, the check engine light is on. I think one of the stability controller is off. Maybe probably a sensor, so we are checking that right now, we're doing it. Charger, Challenger. Let's go with Charger. Challenger wind diesel. I think that's the fame that the Challenger got at the starting. And then the Charger came after the Fast 5, that heist scene, the blacked out. I think Ghost Charger is really, you know, he really liked that. But if I say Mustang is the most unreliable out of all of them. Bro, Asanga is R2 T2. What is R2 T2, man? I am old school, Baba. I am miskin, I am. This is our childhood story. Yes, yes, Asanga. Miraj, I'm so sorry, man. It's a Miraj. He wants to put a Colt engine with an all-wheel system. So probably when he comes back, something will be cooking in our garage. Where is the BMW? The BMW is standing right now in my Ajman shop. It's in my Ajman shop. I just swapped the turbo to a T3. So that I can torque it a bit more. Again, 3-inch complete system, exhaust system 3.5. Not 3.5, 3.25. The outer is 3.5. Other than that, I think I'm going to... I did get a new fuel cell. I upgraded my fuel cell completely. Got a 30 liter in that, so that the fuel surge keeps on going. There's no lack of fuel, and that's why while sliding, you lost control or you lost power. Merging this car talks. Yes, car talks. That's all we're doing. I'm telling my stories. That's all. I love telling stories. Mannan, you just left. Sorry, man. I was so caught up. I had to pick someone up for this live show, and I had to leave. Sorry. Come again. I just saw you posted a walkthrough of this entire thing. Thank you. Maybe this is heaven. So yeah. Nissan Sunny. Baba, Nissan Sunny days. We were so stupid. We should go to the Maliha Road, okay? Maliha had no radars those days. We trying X. Stupid things. One of the incident was, we started handbraking in the roundabout. The car doesn't give, huh? 1.3, the car does not give. We are like, this car will give. And it was an automatic. So we, like, you know, twist your steering completely. Give me, slide. And Nissan Sunny days, we used to, Asanga, you remember those college days when I used to pick up, we used to roam around from Manipal to Heriot-Watt. And I was in Manipal, he was in Heriot-Watt. So we go all these, you know, big cars, G63 and all are parked around there, you know, the Mercedes and all. We are in our sunny, my bonnet is faded. I had a faded bonnet. Like, this is what looking cool, bro. Oh my God. And BM days were so amazing. That's one of the Nissan stories. I probably will make an episode on this Nissan. Thank you, Asanga, for reminding me. This guy, Asanga? So I remember he got his license late after me. And he was driving us to the food court. And I don't know why. I was like, drive. Hey, bro, I can drive. I'm like, drive. We had a... Asanga? Remember the Yaris race we had? 2010? 2011. So that's this Yaris guy. Okay, now I'll tell you the small Asanga and my day story. Asanga had a friend, Jitin, I don't remember his name. Jerry or something. So this guy took the logo of 5.0 from, I think, one of the Mustang or something, posted it on his Yaris. He said, come bro, race. I said, come race. Now I should never let anyone go. My pride was that, you know, level. I never let anyone go in front of us, or in front of me. So we take the roundabout, you know, those days, academic city, no radar, one radar in 50 kilometer, we are thrashing. And I remember this, he's like catching up, and he comes close to me. So all I did was I scared him. I swear Asanga was there, because I made Asanga sit in his car so that the weight will be more and, you know, I will go faster, okay, and I was alone in my car. So I just scared him, you know, like the staring. You come back, I did this. This guy did dune bashing over there with that Yaris. He, because on the desert, like there was this desert, right? There was this poles. I think probably for some construction or something, you know, they'll make a building here. But he avoided everything. Bum, 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 bum. I'm like, oh my God, this guy, I just scared him. And he just went all the way there. So yeah, that was our year. Accord days, Baba, you were disappeared. Don't talk about Accord days, you were somewhere busy. We know that. So I have a Supra. Man, Ford inline 12 engine is you. You are the only one who's so into Fords. I, at least for me, I've seen you with Fords. Remember when you got that the blue Expedition with that code on the door? And I was like, Asanga. His father sold the Explorer or something to a Saudi guy, and his father got the normal Expedition blue in color, and there was this code on the door, and we were like, oh, you know, James Bond, we are that type. Oh, okay. Farhan, no man, no, oh my God. So Asanga is all into Fords. His life is into Fords. That's what I've seen. What do you think about agents? Okay, you really want to know Accord? Okay, Accord and my Civic stories. I and Honda, we don't go along. All my Hondas have either cancelled or I've hit someone. Not hit someone, I hit a wall. I went to hospital for some time because of that. The engine was on my dashboard and I was behind. Honda and I, we don't. I cancelled a rent-a-car. I did screw up a rent-a-car. It was raining and yeah, one of our friend was there with us. What's the best looking stock JDM? To answer your question, 8th gen Civics. Civic itself, I don't know. I want to twist, I want to turn. And then I twist and I turn and then I press brake and the car goes straight when my steering is right. So, yeah. What's the best looking JDM? Stock? I think I like the older Silvia. The Silvia story, the reason I like is, I remember this guy, I was 19, 18, and this guy had a completely built Silvia. It was in Umalkuen after Palma, and his house was there, and I had to go and pick the car. I had to always pay him and then pick the car. And still remember very vividly, he had like five of them. He showed me his personal one. He said, this is my personal one. It's all upgraded. La, 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 la. You open the bonnet, red, blue, green, yellow, all the colors. You know, and I was like, oh, Sylvia, this is, you know, my car. I mean, I can buy this car and make it this. He took me for a drive. I still remember this. So I'm getting used to this, you know, putting my head, my brain is leaving my head. I'm like, oh God, help me, give my brain back. So he's doing this 1, 2, 3 pull. I still don't remember what speed he was. What I remember was he opening something here, opening the hatch, and then pulling something, and then the parachute opens. Oh my God, parachute in a car. I've not even seen videos of that till now, you know. Like somewhere, someone has a parachute in a car. Like those 1000 HPs. And I park the car. And obviously he comes back, takes the parachute in, parks the car, and he says, what do you think? I'm like, definitely I'm going to buy the Silvia and I'm going to give it to you. You do the build. I was 18. I was 18, 19 those days. I like, do the build. I want the same setup. I'm going to, you know, be the king of the road. That's what that era was like that. That era was rebellious. That era had a magic in the air, you know. You wanna do something, you go for it. Now it's all TikTok and all that. I don't know what to say. Now that's the scene. That era was like that. So I still remember I had that guy as like 20,000 or 30,000 something he asked, and I had 8,000 in my pocket. I begged my father, please give me 12,000. I want the Silvia. My father said no. All these years later, now that I think about it, you know, and obviously that time again I was rebellious, I was stupid. A lot of my friends who I meet today, and I, you know, I drive like these and all. So they say, if you don't got that Silvia back in those days, I would probably be in some wall or in some, you know, ditch, somewhere in a hospital. So yeah. I think the Silvia, yeah. Oh, most of my family were built. I can't wear built. But I do wear. Happy to see it growing. Yeah, it's growing. Yeah, we both did have a talk about the back a couple of days. We being us, our men's thing that we do. Thank you to you guys for the 1,000 subscribers, to be very honest. That's how it is. I have more stories to tell. Yes, I am all ears. All ears to listen to you, man. All ears. I will definitely listen to it. Hey, you need to sit there. You have stories to tell, and I love, man. Actually, you're one of those. I mean, your bird and my bird are, you know, one day apart. So I think we both have this connection of telling stories, Taurus connection. So yeah. Close the door. Ouch. Thank you, Mr. Akash. Haram Khor. Sorry, I can't say. Sorry. Amazing Adnan stories. Mr. Adnan needs to come back. Mr. Adnan is a bit bhaufying nowadays. He's a bit busy. What's up? You want me to say that again? Mr. Adnan. Sit, bro. Out of all the days in life, today you choose to bring a friend, huh? Hi. Close the door. Thank you. Okay. If you're going to talk, you come and do live. Mostly I'm going. Adnan's stories were good. Adnan's story was really good.
It's the best. That was the best.
Tell him.
Oh, so sorry.
We'll talk. Adnan's story was always, we were listening. Because he was from the era before us. Before we became haramis, before we became us, he and his group, Rupesh, Latko, James, who else was there? Umair, these all guys were doing it before us. So yeah, that was how it was. Tendram Petrol, yes, Tendram Petrol used to actually give us a million miles. We used to do this. Yeah. Hey Dark Knight, what's up? Abu Shagara was home. 8, 10 hours standing in Abu Shagara. Oh my God. Seeing which car is coming. Seeing, oh my God, that car is here, this car is here. So yeah. Hey Saif, hi, how's your shoots going? How's everything, man? It's a long time, I haven't seen you as well. Please, please do come back with more stories. Hey Mannan, thank you, Habib. Love from Oman, hey. Bro, I never got your name. It's a very am daddy. I know you're daddy, okay, and we are miskins. Yeah. Yes, we used to jump side to side. Yes, we used to. Because that was us, you know. Rebellious, stupid, running. You know, if anyone said right, we had to go left. That's the life that we lived. And it was fun. I have no regrets. Asanga, Adi, Fawad. I don't know what the hell he is right now, nowadays. But yeah, there's no regrets. I have enjoyed. We say, Yare with Jaffin. Yes. He crashed it. He was dune bashing, if you remember. He was dune bashing the whole way. Chamak Yaris, I know, right? That's the reason the race happened, because he put that 5.0 AMG or, oh no, sorry, 5.0 Mustang's logo on the Yaris, and he goes like, whoa, I am, you know, Yaris power. I said, whoa, come. College days, this is what you do. Switch off power for more power, baby. Yes, 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 that's our trick. Please don't disclose everything here. Yeah, right. Rashid is the OG. I am miskin, Baba. I am nothing. I am just a guy. Bro, when all questions finish, you are 34. Sure. But then we are connected to a whole setup here. But definitely, I'll post something from my. Yeah. It's R now. It was a T before. Relive, awesome. Yes, Jan. Relive. You didn't want to go back to those days when we never had money in our pocket. Like, Asang, how much you have? 5 bucks. Adi, how much you have? 2 bucks. Rajit, how much you have? Okay, I have 5 bucks, another. Let's go. Let's play foosball. You didn't want to go back to those days? Or do you want to sit in a ambience place and say, you know what, you made it? I mean, I want reliving. That's the thing. Asanga and I were in grammar school. Eminent. Adi went with me from grammar to Eminent to Manipal. So after all of this, we friends, we just grew up together. And we have enjoyed every part of it. I have no regrets, I'll be very honest. I have to pass by. Yes, Carwolf. Carwolf, even if we end the season with all the videos that we have, we will definitely call you guys, especially the Abu Dhabi guys, B910, Carwolf, and there's a couple of them more who wants to come to the show, but they're stuck in Abu Dhabi. No problem. I, even if the editor or the cameraman are not there, I'll be here. I'll do it myself. Don't worry at all. Oh, mighty 86, Dollywood hero. Oh, I am miskin, man. Mr. Tom Cruise joined us after putting carbon fiber all over his steering wheel. And what you're saying, oh, how low, imagine how the carbon fiber will be. Show it already. Show it, man, what's up? Hey, I told you, it was a GTT and converted to R. No money, no problem, man, trust me. That, I was telling you, Asanga, it was magical. Those days were something else. Oh my God, it was beautiful. We had so much passion, we had so much even if it was something we want to chase, you know, get a degree or get a yay, and that's how it was. No regrets, man, no regrets. I know in the 98, yes, 98, so okay, 98 T, this, that, in the model of 98, this was the R itself, because from 99 onwards the BNR chassis came. So 98 itself was, this is the R. Dollywood hero. Chab Gandu, Dollywood. Oh, sorry. Gandu. I don't care though. Huh? Any new car to add up to the car list? I'm working on a deal with the Hakkasuko. Still working on it. Yeah, I don't think it's attainable till now, but I'm working. I'm going to figure it out. What's up with VTC Valley comes out? VTC is a body catered already. I live in Ajman. Ajman, the rest answer you should be answering yourself. Just did a shoot. Baba, your shoot. So now you answered yourself. I'm Dollywood or you're Dollywood? You answered yourself. Nama. Show the black GT. Yes, yes, yes. I think your uncle's black GT is in my shop. Yes, we're doing the cooler piping for that. Yes, and I'm going to finish that. I'm going to post that very soon. That's probably... I think I need another 2 days with that. We have to reflow, put the flow sensor map sensor in the place where it flows properly. That's what your uncle told me, that he needs the flow to be on the same path where the piping is going through. So I have to figure that out. And yeah, other than that, okay, so I'll tell you a story now that we are already here and everyone is settled down. So I think the camera is everything nowadays. You know, everyone has to have a camera to tell you, you know, oh, I did this in my life or that in my life. Yes, I'll get to that. I will get to that. My T86, I know you need an exhaust, right? I know. Friday I was not there. No, Friday I was there. Friday's use was here. And who was here? Brendan was here, the Man Plus machine. What do you consider a building? Bosuzoku Baba. You drive, take Bosuzoku out, see shadow of Sharjahs, they'll take your car. So don't talk. Okay, Bosuzoku you'll do here. Asanga, they should answer you. You know what I meant. VVTI or non-VVTI? See, the non-VVTI, the old ones, the problem is they're almost 30 years old now. Like, even if you get them, you have to rehaul them. The VVTIs are the new one. Okay, the VVTIs, one problem I really hate is the electronical throttle. It can give you a proper headache. I've done with this. I've done this. Okay, one after one. The black GT, okay. Exhaust giveaway, yes. Hey Umar Farooq is proper, you know, he's another level. He's not with us. Umar Farooq is Arbab, big Arbab. I was there in the shop, bro. I was there. What's the gist? College student. Bro, it's on your budget. It's completely on your budget. If you have a budget, a normal budget, then give me your budget. I'll probably suggest you something. Again, oh, haram. Bosuzoku, sorry. Not happening. Not this Friday. Bhai Bengali, te kisu bolen Bengali. Yes. Bengali te kisu bolen. Okay, now I miss talking in Bengali. I mean, I miss words. That's my main problem. I mean, Bengali kotha bolti pari, but I miss words. Like, oh, I will be like, come on, how are you? You know, like, I do this. I've not been to that place for a really long time, so I've been trying to be, you know, up and down. So yeah, that's how it is. Back to the story. I'll tell you the story, then I'll tell you about the giveaway, because giveaway has to happen. As a promise that we did when the channel started. The problem that happened was there's a lot of personal change that happened in the channel itself. Let's be very honest about it. People have different ideas to take this channel in different paths. I had a different idea. I wanted to tell stories. I wanted to make it a talk show. So I wanted to make it an exclusive only show. I was like, no, this is going to be for everyone. And anyone who have a passion of cars, no matter what car you have, you are invited here. It was never going to be, oh, only that special drifter or only that special someone who reviews cars or those kind of people. No. Anyone who has a passion for car, that you love your car, you're welcome here. If the admin has not scotted you, you will get scotted. Don't worry about it. And or probably you have my Instagram as well. You can always contact me, and I can set something up. I think we are a bit caught up till next Friday, and after that I'm free. I have a couple of people I have to give a photo shoots as well too. Not this Friday. Bangalita to bolsi bhai. What about Altezza? How's the fuel consumption? Altezza non-VVTI? Altezza VVTI with the NA? I like the car. You can do a lot of things with that. A lot of options are there. So yeah, I like it. Now, fuel consumption, I'll be very honest. There are people I put 100 dirham, I get 600 kilometer. I put 50 dirham, I get 5,000 kilometer. There are. I don't care. I do not care about my car. How much it drinks, let it drink. She's a part of my family. You know? America, wow, badass, you are, that's why you are. Wow, miskeen I am, Farhan. I think we need to go out again. I really think we need to go out again. Welcome, Mr. Omar. Thank you, bro. Altis a shit for fuel. Again, depends. You know, clean the injectors, throw up the fuel line. Ma, my battery is dying. You harami. You idiot. You not good things you can't do in life. Chudail here. Madam, please, behan meri, stay away. That is a shit for you. Okay. I can't. You can. Depends on the condition as well. So, yeah. How much does it cost? I think in Japan, if you do it, $12,000. I think I still have the quotation of $12,000. That's how much they charge. Altiza ECU, no, SC300 ECU is different. There is a code difference in this, in the Altiza and the ECU. Ashad, I'm coming. Where are you coming, harami? I'm blessed to have lived memories with you, bro. The honor is mine. I'm honored to have friends like you guys with whom I grew up with. Idiots. And the truth, who cares? Exactly. I really don't care about fuel. What engine, sir? Mustang engine, the one that I really admire was the Shelby 5.0. 5.0 Shelby, I had it for some time. Oh, thank you. Traction light is on. I'll tell you this incident. I was going to Abu Dhabi. I had to take the military exit, for Zayed military camp. Usually those days Abu Dhabi was 160, the radar was at. So I'm at 180, fifth gear, drop down from fifth to third, because I had to, you know, race clutch and enter. And I thought, okay, traction is on, everything is on, and I'll slide. I'll go in the exit. I'm expecting my speed to come down to 110 something, and I can, you know, just smoothly transition it. What happened was the traction light was still on, blinking, and I was doing donuts. Thank God I did not hit anything. It was like 4 in the morning. Because my friend who was with me had his service started at 6 a.m. At 6 a.m. his service was about to start, and I have to drop him to Abu Dhabi. And they need him at the door at 6 a.m. So we reach like fast, and then we'll be sleeping in the car. He'll change up, I'll drop him, take money for fuel from him, and then come back to the way. So that's how it is. That's how one of the story was. And I came back after the donut, and I was like, bro, Mustang 5.0. I respect, it's a beast. It's a proper beast. But will I risk my life for it? So yeah, apart from that, about the exhaust giveaway. Oh, it's almost an hour. It's an hour we're talking, huh?
Camera heat up, got over, so we are
done. Okay. If I have to tell you a story, this is this one that VK Subaru came and reminded me of. What happened was, he was talking about how you change a short shifter, your gear to a short shifter one, and there's a pin that holds. I think Drone Media just posted a video how you change your gears or short shifter and all that, and you try to, you know, drive it with the shifter, it shifts fast. What I didn't see, or maybe I forwarded it, was that there's a pin that holds that shifter knob down there. And VK Subaru came in a couple of two weeks ago, and he said us the story that he had the same incident, and he had to take it to one of the garages, and they quoted like expensive price to fix that. And he said, you know what, no, I'm gonna go back, and fix it to the guy who gave me the short shifter. And it was just a pin. So that reminded me of the story that happened when I had my red BMW. And that BMW and I was my home. That BM, I lived months in that BM, months. I used to go home only to, like, you know, because mom was there. Mom used to, okay, you know, have food and all something. But the moment father comes home, I'm out. And I live outside. Rebel, no? We were rebel in those days. So, living in that BM, still remember Maliha Road, no radar, flat, thrashing the car. 200, 220, 220, 220, it was a 328 maroon color. I still have, I have only one picture of that car. When police impounded it and I got it back and there was no engine and all that. And that one picture is the only one I have. So whenever I tell a story, we always tell people that, guys, give us photos of your cars or your first car and all that. And whenever I'm going to tell this story, I don't know how I will say it, but there's no pictures. This car practically doesn't exist, but this car is there in my life. So this is a story that's really good, important to me. And we were driving, and I'm sitting, friend is driving. Goes to like fifth gear, drops the gear down. It doesn't go in the gear. So the gearbox is literally like this. Yeah, I had a Momo spring gearbox, the design on my gearbox. And I'm like, man, no, you're joking with me. So he goes like, bro, the car is, the gearbox is a milkshake. I'm like, oh, is the car is a, gearbox is a milkshake. Oh, it doesn't go in any gear. I'm like, oh shit, what happened? So we just let the car go as it's going and we stop. Fortunately, that was one of the last street lights. Darkness on the right side, darkness on the left side. That was the route to Oman those days. That people use that road, go towards I think Kalba side, and then from there they go to Oman. I said, okay, no problem. That's the route, right? Let's sort this out. We got a lot of people who were going towards Oman that day. Yeah, more stories. Yeah, I know. No. It was a manual transmission, the GTT that I had. Which engine oil? Engine oil, I think, open the cap. When you open the cap, inside is written which engine oil is the best for your engine. What engine oil is, yeah, that's the understand. Okay. 34 backfire rev is supposed to go to your uncle. You have to figure that out. No, it was a manual. It comes manual. Yeah, that's how it comes. Okay, most of you know. Okay, so let's get into the story. Darkness, both sides. We go like, okay, what do we do next? We had a lot of people from Oman in the bridge. They came, they stopped, tried to, you know, help us and all that. I think our 1 hour is getting over. It shows one something remaining. Yeah. Okay, so I'll tell the story in some other way. The exhaust giveaway, yes, we are supposed to do that. Lot of personal change happened in our channel. Lot of people left, new people came in. What we will do is I will have to do a draw. That's probably the way I want to do it, especially with the guests who came in. So if you are a guest who has already come in and we reached 1,000, I'm going to make the names in small chits and then, you know, sort this out, make their names come up. And yeah, that's how I think we're going to do the exhaust giveaway. Probably once we're done with the schedule, or we could do it in a live stream. Let us know if that's what you guys want, that we'll come live again for the exhaust giveaway and we'll do it live. It's okay. As long as our sponsor, I mean, basically me, is there, I'll figure it out. I'm not worried. Yeah, thank you guys. Thank you. It's an hour I've been speaking. And yeah, apparently what happened is, if I want to end the BM story, was we ended up putting the car only on third gear, driving all the way from Maliha to Sharjah, and the pin, we didn't know where to fix the pin properly. So we just locked it in and we were like, if this is on reverse gear, We are going reverse all the way to Sharjah from Maliha. So it ended up in a third gear. We had to drive at 100 all the way back, and that's how the story ends. Thank you guys. Thank you for coming. Exhaust, please. Okay. Please, let's give away the exhaust. That's what Anas. I would really suggest you come here, do the scrolling, do it. Okay. Okay, so this is the post. This is where the comment section is, and in the comment section, I'm gonna randomly might take six. Sorry, randomly choose someone. We have how many comments?
125+.
Okay, ready? So yeah, I think I need to show my phone in my hand and do this. Okay. You're gonna hold the phone? No. Okay, ready? I'm not gonna see names. I'm trying to go to the last.
Okay.
Look here, as in what? Show the phone here and do. Okay. But then see, Ayua.
Do one thing. Look at the phone, scroll, but don't look at the phone. Look at the camera and scroll.
Okay. Okay, so this is what you guys want me to do. I will do it. End of the day, I have to give the comment section open. What is this? Why doesn't this happen with all those other guys? You forgot to comment, Jibran. Sorry, bro. You missed it. You should have come. Duck. I will not see. Mighty 86. I wish it was a voting thing. Also, you could do this. I keep it here. See, it went to some other's post. I'll keep it here. Scroll. Scroll. Choose a winner. Look at me. Don't look at the phone. Scroll. Choose a winner. Go ahead. Okay. Who did you choose? VK? No, Mr. Who is this? Oh, okay. VK Subaru. WRX.
This is what I
chose,
yeah.
WRX, VK.
VK Subaru, WRX.
VK! What's up, man? Raheel. Man, sorry. Missed it. Hey, Saira. What's up? Saira did that drawing. Saira, thank you for the drawing. But we are in the... Use a randomizer app. No, we do it like this. Randomizer app, then again, this is bias. We just did it in front of you. So VK Subaru, right? Let me open his profile. Yep, VK. This is the profile. VK, I need you here ASAP. We will get your exhaust thing done. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Next target is 2000 subscribers. Maybe 2525, that's a good year. The moment we touch 2500 subs on our YouTube channel, we are going to give probably something else. I don't know, I can't think right now. We'll make a post, 25 subscribers we reach, and that's it.